In addition to introducing a new smaller Apple TV on Wednesday, Apple CEO Steve Jobs announced a refresh line of iPods.
This is the new iPod Touch. It's even thinner. Let me go back again. That's the current one that's really thin. This is the new one. It's even more beautiful. Here's the top with the sleep-wake button, bottom with the same 30-pin connector, headphone jack, little speaker port.
The iPod Touch, now the most popular iPod, will get front and back cameras and Apple's FaceTime video conferencing application. It also will get a high-definition Retina display, the same one used in the iPhone 4. It starts at $229 and is available now. Meanwhile, the iPod Nano will get a very tiny multi-touch interface and a clip, like the one on the smaller Shuffle, for attaching to your clothes during sports activities. If that turns the display upside down, you can now flip it back using the touch screen. The Nano starts at $149. Also, the iPod Shuffle got its button controls back and is available now for $49. Also at the event, Apple announced that it's getting into social networking with a tool called Ping.
In iTunes 10, we're announcing something really cool, and we call it Ping. And what Ping is it's a social network for music. It's sort of like Facebook and Twitter meet iTunes.
Ping is focused on music and lets users share what they've been listening to and what concerts they're going to, as well as follow updates from their favorite artists. It taps into approximately 160 million iTunes users worldwide. Apple also announced iOS 4.1, an update to the iPhone, iPad, and iPod Touch software that fixes some bugs and adds the Game Center gaming network, high dynamic range photography, and the ability to upload full HD videos over Wi-Fi. With reporting by Stephen Lawson in San Francisco, I'm Nick Barber, IDG News Service.